The next item that we can configure through advanced appearance settings is icon. You can change the size of icons, their font style, font size, and you can make the font bold and italic. Default value of font size is 32, and maximum size that you can define is 72. Before we move further, let me show you the same settings for icon in Windows XP. In Windows XP, to access the same settings, right-click on your desktop and choose Properties. In the Display Properties window, click on Appearance, and then click on Advanced button. Here you will see all the advanced appearance items, which we are configuring in Windows 7. Here, choose Icon, change the size to 50, and apply the changes. You will notice that the size of the desktop icons has increased. In Windows 7, this command works a little differently. First of all, in Windows 7, you can easily increase the size of your desktop icons, without moving to advanced appearance settings. Just right-click on an empty area of your desktop, and move your mouse pointer to View. Here you will see a further list of commands. As you can see that, you have three predefined choices for icon size, which are large icons, medium icons, or small icons. As I choose medium size, or large size, you can immediately notice the changes in the size of desktop icons. I set them back to small icons again. But if I configure the same settings from Advanced Appearance window, and choose 72 as the size for my icons, I am also changing the font style, font size, and making the text more darker, by choosing bold. You will notice that everything has changed except for size of the icons. But if you look carefully, then you can see that the size of title for icons has increased. So, in my opinion, it will be better to choose the size of icons from predefined sizes. You can also increase the size of your desktop icons, using a simple shortcut. Just hold down the control key from your keyboard, and scroll the wheel of your mouse up or down to increase or decrease the size. If you again want the default size, just choose one from predefined sizes. From context menu, the icon settings will not only apply to the desktop icons, but for almost every icon you see in Windows. Like, if I open Start menu or Documents folder, you can see the same appearance settings for all the icons. The next two items in advanced appearance settings are icon spacing horizontally and icon spacing vertically. The both items will define the horizontal and vertical spacing between two desktop items. As you can see that, I have placed some more icons on my desktop, so you can clearly understand the concept of horizontal and vertical spacing of icons. As I increase the horizontal spacing of icons from 43 to 80, and apply the changes, you can notice that the gap between two icons has horizontally increased. With the same way, you can increase the vertical spacing between two icons. I am changing the default value of this item from 43 to 80 as well, and you can see that the spacing between icons has also increased vertically. Do note that the default value of icon spacing horizontally, and icon spacing vertically will not change, even if you change the theme. Do note down their default values before you make any changes, so if something goes wrong, you can revert back by entering the default values manually. Previously, we had configured the properties of active title bar, and I had described to you about the active and inactive title bars. The next item that we are going to configure is inactive title bar. Here you can configure the size of the inactive title bar, colors, font style, font size, and font color. But we will only change the colors of inactive title bar. This is because all the other settings will get applied to both active and inactive title bars. To change and check the settings, I right-click on the taskbar and choose Properties. Now, I have two windows open simultaneously. The window in which you are currently working is called Active Title Bar, and for now, my active title bar is Advanced Appearance Settings. As I change both the colors of inactive title bar item and apply the changes. You can see that our inactive window has the same colors that we had defined. Next, we are going to configure inactive window border size. You can define a different border size for your inactive windows. For instance, I right-click on desktop and choose personalize. I restore its window. Then I click on Windows Color. Now, I have two windows on my screen. I change the size of inactive window border from 1 to 10 and apply the changes. See that, our inactive personalize window now have a different size than our color and appearance window. Before we change the properties of our next item, which is menu, let's first open a separate window of Notepad, so you can understand the changes which we are going to make. I open Notepad and move it the right side of the screen. Window will automatically adjust the size of the window using arrow snap feature, as I had described in my previous lessons. Now, I increase the size of menu from 18 to 30, changing the color style, and then I increase the font size from 8 to 10, and a different font color as well. After applying the changes, you can see the changes in Notepad menu bar. If you click on Start menu, you can see the same color style. But if I open WordPad, then you will notice that the WordPad menu has not the same color and style. Because some of modern programs use a different style of menus, other than classic style. Message box: if you change the color style, and font color of this item, then it will get applied to all the messages box that appear while working in Window. Even the current window is a kind of message box. So, let's configure some settings and change the font color for message box. As I apply the changes, you can see the color of the text of current window has also changed. Moreover, whenever you will see a message box, then it will have the same colors that you have defined. Palette title: I have to give you an example of this item in Windows XP, because I didn't find any palette item in Windows 7. Palette title is a kind of menu that can move or adjust it from their position. Like, I open paintbrush, and the color box below is a palette item, which can be moved by dragging and dropping. So, now if I change the properties of palette title and apply the changes, you can see the result here. Scroll bar appears in every window when the contents get larger than the screen size, so you can easily scroll the window up and down using your mouse. You can also increase the size of scroll bar according to your preference. If you think that the size is too small or large, then you can adjust it accordingly. Just change the size and see the changes in every scroll bar. The default color for selected item is blue, but if you consider having a different color and size for the selected items, then choose selected items and define different foreground and background colors. Now, whenever you will select an item from desktop, it will have the same color scheme. These changes will also get affected in text editing programs like Notepad or WordPad. When you will select a text, then they will have the foreground and background colors that you have decided. Tool tips are the system messages which appear when you move your mouse pointer over certain items. You can have different foreground and font color for those messages as well. Just choose your favorite colors and apply the changes. Now, whenever you will move your mouse pointer over an item which has a tool tip, the tool tip will get display in your favorite colors. You can also configure your favorite colors for the inside area of a window. Just select the colors you want for background and font, and they will appear everywhere in the windows. I hope that you may now have a good understanding of advanced appearance settings. If something goes wrong, then just change the window theme, and everything will adjust it according to the theme. If you are satisfied with your settings and do not want to lose them, then just save all of them as a theme. As you can see that, even after changing the theme, the icon size, icon spacing horizontally, and icon spacing vertically have not changed. So, do note down their default values. Icon's default size is 32, icon spacing horizontally is 43, and icon spacing vertically 43. In our next video, we will cover more useful features of Windows 7. Till then, keep subscribing to our channel and have a nice day.